What up? It's your boy Busy Blake. Bring you another rank live, not live, but rank match online. This game I'm playing my homeboy, man. We play pretty often. This is probably like our sixth or seventh game. He has yet to beat me on Madden, keep in mind. And this is the first game I recorded of us playing. So, you know, right off jump, man, he's using the 49ers, and he made a nice little play with a little help from the game. Broke a few tackles, but, hey, that's where we play a game. So you're going to get stuff like that to happen to you sometime. It's going to happen for you also, but that time it went his way. So I'm in a deep hole. Not a deep hole, but I'm in a hole starting off the game. But it's no big deal because he got the ball first. I just got to come down and answer that score, and I'll be all right. But, you know, most of the time we play, man, every time I've won on this Madden 12, every time we've played, and it's normally a double-digit lead. So a lot of times it's a close game up until, like, he start making mistakes. I force him into some mistakes, but let's get into this game, and so you can see what happened, man. But he's kind of playing pretty good D there, homie. It's a 3rd and 10. I decided to run a draw. I was kind of conservative on that play. Then I decided to go for it on 4th, and he made a play. That's what it's all about, man. When you're trying to beat one of your nemesis, you have to make plays, man. You got to try to get them out their comfort zone. But I'm knowing I have to make a defensive stop because he already have a 7-point lead on me, so I have to make a play, and I end up holding him, 3 and out. I get the ball back, and we're still in the first quarter, so we got a lot of football left. But the reason I showed that punt, man, because he got a kick catch interference or something. Gave me about an extra 10 or 15 yards. But, I hit him with that screen, and Mendenhall, he made a little play, a little move at the end to get me back into the game, 7-7 off. Kicked the ball off. Thought I was in good position to make a play in the backfield for a loss, but kind of like this play, but he was able to gain good positive yards on that first down. Held him again. It's 3rd down, but I held him to 3rd down. I didn't hold him on that 3rd down. He got that 1st down, so we rolled into the 2nd quarter, man, tied 7-all. Looked like we got a ball game on our hands, man. Gore's kind of, he was cranking it up with Gore on me. Gore made a lot of big plays this game. But this is one of the mistakes I normally force him into. He thought he had something across the middle. I like to keep that middle on lock and let everything else fall into place. But I like to defend that middle, force my opponent to find other alternatives. And if he's good enough, my opponent can force me into trying to guard something other than the middle so he can exploit my middle. So. But, actually, I had to punt. I pinned him into the fire, inside the fire. But, he was on this game, man. I got to give it to him. Looked like we got something that might go down to the wire, man, because he's not backing down. And he's doing a lot of running, so, and look. Gore gashing me, man. Hell of a play. Got to give it to him. But Madden, they called holding on him. So he called clipping. So he had to bring that one back. But he still had the 1st down because that block was made way upfield. Brought him back to around the 45 or something. He ran that same play. Same positive results. I'm sure he's going to come back to that at some point. So I'm going to have to I'm gonna have to get my run D on lockdown. And I was able to, he ran it again there. I was able to kind of, stall that counter. But look at this, man. 7-8 Pittsburgh Steelers. We let Alex Smith break around him. One of my guys knocked him around all my coverage. Now he's up 14-7. We almost at halftime. So. That's how he ran that kickoff back, because my man, he I don't know if it was because I did the hit stick. He didn't hit him that good. He knocked him around all the coverage. So. I went for it on that fourth down, man. I'm knowing I got a game on my hands. So. But if you had noticed, he started, he was leaving that middle wide open. Can't leave Mike Wallace much space, because he'll take that ball and he'll exploit your defense, man. He's so fast. He just threw this one up, man. And they gave it to him. But I thought he should have settled probably for a field goal here. He's trying to get greedy, which most of us do. Threw a pick. Instead of going up 17-14, going in the half with a three-point lead, look like we're going to be tired if I can keep from making a mistake down here. I wanted to kneel the ball, but I was so close to the end zone. It's kind of scary. Big Ben was going to kneel the ball in the end zone, give me a safety, so I decided to run the ball. But on to the second half. It's 14-14. This is nothing new. This is familiar when me and him play. Pretty close game. I just hadn't forced them into those devastating mistakes yet. But his, I don't know what kind of defense he was running, but it was leaving stuff wide open, especially across that middle. So until he changed something, I'm gonna continue to exploit that. And also, I really don't like Pittsburgh's, I'm not big on Mendenhall, man. He don't have great breakaway speed. I mean, he's just a very average running back on this game to me. In real life also. But, steady hit him across the middle, man. I tested his user skills on that play. He failed. So I run it in with Big Ben on the QB sneak. But this is a very crucial time for my partner, the one stunner. And a lot of times this is where the game gets out of hand for him. If I come back and I can make a stop, but he's making plays. He making plays this game. I got to give it to you. The one stunner deserves his credit for on this one. So I end up going into the fourth quarter, 3rd and 10. I'm up 7. He got the ball. All I need to make is stop, and it's probably it still be a lot of ball game left. But I'm pretty sure it would be hard for him to win. But he made a play on 3rd and 10, and. Gore just ran it on in. I don't know what my defense was doing. So we tied now, man. Now I can't make a mistake. I can't make a mistake. All I can do is just capitalize on something like this. Check me out. Mike Wallace. Didn't work out for me, though. I don't know how Big Ben overthrew Mike Wallace in that situation, but he did. So, I'm going on a nice little methodical drive, steady exploiting that inside, that middle. But I'm looking at this point knowing I gotta make something happen, because if I don't, he gets the ball back, and he's been fairly decent offensively against my defense. And that was a dangerous pass. It looked like he made some kind of change. And I thought I would be able to, since he got those three down linemen, I thought I would be able to run the ball up the gut. But this time, you see, I made the mistake. And it looked like he got the game in his hand. Could have returned that for a touchdown. He definitely would have been looking good. But, I got all my time out, so I'm gonna have to, I have to stop him here, three and out. Pretty sure he'll kick his field goal. So, I have to batten down the hatches. And, but check him out on this play, man. Since they called that holding, I started pulling my men back, but look what he started doing. That just, that's not understanding the game there, man. It's always something that come back to bite him when he playing. And that was his fault. That was a stupid move on his part there. But, so I come back and play soft coverage on 3rd and 46, which was my fault. I let him get in good field goal range. And, he was able to knock it down. I should have been a little more aggressive on that 3rd and 46, but you learn. So I got to come down and get in field goal range. Decides to hit him up the gut with Big Ben. I don't have no more timeouts, but I got enough time to get things done. Had enough time to throw that pick too, just to seal the game, man. Big props to my homeboy, man, the one stunner. He was able to put together enough plays to get the win. So there you have it, man. Busy Blake. If you like my videos, go ahead and subscribe, man. I have more coming soon. Thank you for watching, and check back, man.